So I needed a new YouTube banner for Maker Thrive, but I didn't feel like opening Figma and messing around with alignment guides for an hour. Instead, I typed a prompt into AI and let it handle all of the layout. In this video, I'll show you how to use Venngage's AI YouTube banner generator to make 3 clean branded banner variations in less than 10 minutes. Safe zone checked, mobile friendly, and ready to publish. Let's jump in. Okay, so I'm starting from the Venngage homepage. I'm heading to social media and then I'll go to banner. And then here I'm going to paste my prompt, design a modern clean YouTube banner for Maker Thrive with a technology theme with space for logo plus short tagline, prioritize the safe zone. I'll click generate posts and then it's going to begin generating my YouTube banner. So we got our banner back. This looks great. Let's go ahead and customize it. We'll just click customize. Okay, so as you can see, it did prioritize our safe zone. So on different screen sizes, we'll be able to see all of these different things. We have a space for our tagline, a space for our logo, some links, and then also a call to action to subscribe. And then this is where our logo will go. So I'm gonna go ahead and replace this actually. Go to replace, and then I'm gonna go to brand kit, and then I'll put one of our logos here. So that looks great. And then another thing I can do now that I'm in the brand kit is shuffle through our palettes and apply all of our color and our fonts to this design. So I can do this here. I like that. And then I can apply our fonts so I can make everything pop-ins. And now what we're gonna do is go to AI tools and I'm gonna generate a couple icons. So this one is for a movie channel. I'm going to actually do a gradient one, and I'm gonna do tools white and generate this icon. Okay, awesome. I like this one, so I can go ahead and replace this and place this here. I think that looks great. I can align it with that. And then another thing is we actually don't use our Facebook that much, but we do use TikTok. So I'm going to do TikTok logo, and then we'll do monotone, generate icons. Amazing, so we got that back. We will place this here instead of Facebook, make it a bit smaller, make sure that's aligned. And then now let's generate our tagline with using the AI text generator. So all I need to do is click into this text and then go to improve text. And I'm gonna paste a super simple prompt here, create a tagline that empowers people to build online smarter, 5 to 6 words max. I'll send this, and then we have build online smarter, stronger. I think that's great. It's clear and to the point. I'll replace this section. And then now I have my tagline. I can make this a little bit smaller so it's all one line. And then I can also apply my text to it as well. Let's shuffle this brand kit because I did add some things. Amazing. So I think we're in a really good spot. Maybe I can replace this icon to a different color. I can do this one. And then now I can change the color so it matches. And I think this looks really, really good. And then just a note here, if you do move some things around, you can see that we have these guides everywhere to prioritize the safe zones. You can also, if you go to file up here and go to page settings, you can show margins, you can show your grid so that you can prioritize your safe zones. And then you can also show the print bleed. We don't need that for this use case, but the margins in the grid are super helpful if you need some extra help. Now that we're in a good spot and I like my design, what we're gonna do is run our design feedback. So if I go to AI tools, I can go to design feedback and the AI is going to automatically analyze my design and suggest any design edits. So let's let this run for a few seconds and then we can come back once we have our result. Okay, awesome. So we got a couple feedbacks. Enhanced visibility and clarity of social media links. The social media icons and text Facebook, Instagram, X are too small for easy readability and quick identification. Increase their size and ensure consistent visual styling for better scannability. I think that is a great suggestion. So what I'm gonna do is select all of these, zoom in some more, and then I can just make these icons a little bit larger and then make sure I stay within these margins that I placed for myself. Can move this text up, and then obviously these would be your ads. I'm not gonna add this in this example, but that's where that text would be. And then we also got another piece of feedback, remove the ambiguous directional arrow. This large curve arrow is visually distracting and it is exact purpose to indicate clickable elements or simply point. It's not clearly communicated. Remove it to reduce visual clutter and improve focus. I think that's a great suggestion as well. So we'll go ahead and delete that. So if you do need some help with your design, go ahead and run that. You can rescan it as well once you've also added some more elements or taken away elements and see where you're at. Okay, so I'm super happy with this. Now that I'm happy with my design, I can duplicate this and make some different versions. So what I'm gonna do is go to File and then Make a Copy. I'm going to be taken into our copy, and what I'm gonna do here is actually name this dark. So this one that we were just on will be my light version. This one can be my dark version. Let's go to the brand kit and we're gonna shuffle through this palette till we get a nice dark version. I'm mostly focusing on the icons here until I'm happy with it, okay? So now I have a dark one. I like this one. I can change this background color to this lighter purple. I can change this to white, and then maybe I can put a border behind this image so that you can tell it's there. What I'm gonna do is go to shapes and lines. I'm gonna add a circle, and then I'm gonna go to fill color. I can make this pink. I'm gonna make it just slightly larger than the logo itself. Make sure that's aligned. And then what I'm gonna do is go to layers, move to back, move forward, move forward. Awesome, and then now I have a nice border around my logo. I can move this over a bit. I could make this one a little bit larger. So this would be my dark version. I think it looks awesome. Now let's make one more copy. And we can name this one gradient. So now let's try to make a gradient background. I can go back to AI tools. I can go to generate images. I can do neon gradient background, generate that. Okay, we got some results back. I think this space one is super cool. So I can add this. And what I can do is just make it my new background. And then I can go back to layers, move it to the back, then move it forward a couple times. Awesome, so now I have a really fun gradient background. I can adjust this logo again. I think that looks super fun. So as a recap, we have a gradient version. We have our dark version, which looks super cool. And then we also have a light version. So I can rotate these. I can move these three versions and test across all of our platforms. So if you're not seeing results from one, try out the next one. Maybe one is more visually appealing than the other. So now let's test this really quickly. We'll test the gradient one. To download it, all you have to do is go up here to download, and then I'm gonna download it as a PNG. So I'll download this image, and then what I'll do is I'll go to YouTube, edit this, and then I can test this out. Okay, so we can go to change, and then we can open our banner. And then as you can see, we get all of our different screen sizes. So viewable on TV will be the entire thing. Viewable on desktop is going to be these two boxes, and then viewable on all devices, specifically mobile. You can see our logo and then the really nice gradient border. So this looks amazing. We can update that, and then we can also test the other versions that we made. So if you're launching a channel or just want your YouTube to look more polished, try the AI YouTube banner generator for free. And try out all the different AI tools that they have, and also check out their templates. There's some great ones in there. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.